Okay, dear students, good morning. And I hope that you are feeling much better. I am going to take in your class today. We are discussing about the chapter of rational number. And in last class, I told you that what is the properties of rational number. And I remember you that very few months ago. Rational number is that some property, if the condition satisfied in this matter, that we can say that this is rational number. First of all, that we can say that first equation is that any digit in the form of p by q. Any digit in the form of p by q, then we can say that another condition where p and q also integers. I told you that I hope that you understand properly, and I will memorize that in last class what I told you. Properties of rational number in the form of any rational number or any ratio p by q, where p and q are integers, and I hope and also I memorize that rational number is that negative numbers and also whole number. This is indicated to integers, and p in this ratio p and q also integers, and third condition satisfied, q not equal to 0. If third condition satisfied in any type of ratio, then we can say that that ratio indicated to rational number. And I hope you understand properly. Today we will discuss what is the another properties of rational number and how can we solve any type of rational number. So dear students, open your book page number 6 and we will discuss something properties. First of all, let me begin to how can you solve any type of equations. Like some properties, if plus multiply by plus, then we can find out the symbol of plus. It's most important in any type of questions. If you calculate very easily, then find out any type of resultant very easily. If plus multiply by minus, then find out minus. If multiply symbol, if minus symbol is multiplied by minus, then we can find out plus. And minus multiply by plus, this is find out minus. If you remember this symbol, then we can solve very easily any type of question. So page number 6, dear students, open your book. On page number 6, we will discuss some properties. First property is closure property. What is the closure property? Let me explain, dear students. Closure property means if A upon B and C upon D. If A upon B and C upon D are rational numbers, then how can we solve this equation? In your book, suppose that I am writing here one equation, 1 upon 2 and 3 upon 4, and find out sum. Question is that how can we find out the sum of 1 upon 2 and 3 upon 4? You have to know first of all addition property. How can we add any type of rational number or any type of ratio? You have to know first of all, like I am writing here 1 upon 2 plus 3 upon 2. In this questions, we saw that denominator are same. This is numerator and this is indicated to denominator. If denominator are same in any equations or question, then we can add numerator 1 plus 3 upon 2. If in this condition, if denominator are same, then we can write here 3 plus 1, 4 upon 2, and divided, cancel out 4 by 2, answer is true. But another condition is that if denominator is different, then how can we solve? I am writing another questions and I hope that you understand properly that how can we solve this question. First condition is apply that I remember always, if denominator is same then we can solve directly numerator adding, but if denominator is different then how can we solve? Like that I am writing here 2 upon 4 plus 3 upon 5. Dear students, how can you solve these equations? Because here is the not denominator are same. So I told you in last class, first of all you have to find out LCM. And what is the LCM? I told you lowest common factor in any numbers are digit. If any type of numbers which is interacted to all means like 2, 4, 6, 8. In this series, if we find out the common number, then 2 is interrupted in this digit and also 6 and also 8. And with the divided method 4 and 5, we will find out, trying to find out how can we find out the LCM. 4 and 5, you have to divide it from lowest to higher number. First of all, we divide it from 2, 2 to the 4, and not divided by 5, then we can write down same number. Then we will divide it by 2. Also 2 1 the 2 and 5 here, then divided by 5 and also write down 1 and 1. If remainder is 1 and 1, in this condition we will leave them and we will calculate this all numbers like 2 multiply by 2 multiply by 5. And I hope that you can calculate very easily 2 to the 4 multiply by 5 and also find out the final result 5 for the 20. Then we can say that, then how can we find these equations? The question is that in your book page number 6, what is the sum of 1 upon 2 and 3 upon 4? So dear students, you remember that first condition, if denominator is same, then we can add directly. But second condition says that if denominator is different, then first of all we have to take an LCM. And I hope that you can find out what is the procedure of LCM. Like we will find out, first of all write down questions 1 upon 2 and 3 upon 4. And first condition and first step is first of all find out LCM. What is the LCM of 2 and 4? And I hope that you can understand properly what is the procedure. Till that I have told you 2 and also 4. First of all divided by the smallest number, 2 divided by 1 and 2 also, and 1 is the 1. If 1 is remainder, then leave them and multiply by this all digit. 2 multiply and 2, here you can find out 4. Then we can see that LCM of 2 and 4 is 4. Then we can solve here 1 upon 2 plus 3 upon 4, and taking LCM 2 and 4 is the 4. First of all, this step is, as you know that in this condition, firstly we will divide it between these denominators 4 and 2. Then we can find out 2 and multiply by that result in numerator. So what is the value of in this condition? 2 2 is 4 and 2 multiply by 1, 2 1 is 2. Here is the 2 and same procedure is 4 1 is 4. So 4 divided by 4 and you will find out the answer 1, and 1 is multiplied by numerator like 3, 3 1 is 3. Then we can add very easily 2 and 3, 5 upon 4. This is the answer of these equations. The question is that, dear students, in this your book, page number 6, first property is closure property, and say that what is the sum of 1 upon 2 and 3 upon 4. And I told you once again, like first of all, you have to check that denominator same or different. If same, then you can direct add. If the different of the denominator, then first of all find out the LCM, and with the help of LCM, you can add this equation. And the last answer is the 5 upon 4. Next properties we will discuss, commutative law. What is the commutative law? Before that properties, I am asking about questions and I hope that you will solve very easily. question is that 12 upon 8 plus 7 upon 12. Dear students, this questions of you and try to solve yourself and reply in comment that what is the your answer find out. Then we will come on the your exercise. All properties related to this, if we solve this type of equation, like plus, first of all you have to know that what is the multiplication of this symbol plus and minus, then you can solve very easily any type of property. And I hope that you understand properly. If you have any problem, then you can solve, ask me, and I hope that I will solve and I will remove all your doubts. Now come on to your exercise. Page number 10. Exercise first. Dear students, open your book. Page number 10, exercise 1C. You saw question number first, add the following rational number. Question number first, it says that minus 2 upon 5 plus 4 upon 5. Dear students, I told you before some time that how can we solve this type of questions. First of all, you have to check that what is the condition of denominator. If denominator is same in this condition, then we can add directly 4 and 2. But and before some time told you that what is the condition in this plus and minus. If you don't know that, you can solve these questions. First of all, if we add like minus and also plus, what is the plus and minus? Make it to each other. There is the final result minus. Here is the plus minus 2 and here is the plus 2. With the LCM also I can find out, but directly we can save our time. Also I can write down 4 upon 5 minus 2 upon 5. Because in this question, this term is plus position and this term is minus position. And we can change that position, 4 upon 5 minus 2 upon 5. And here find out 4 minus 2 upon 5. And you can find out very easily the equations 3 upon 5. Sorry, 2 upon 5. This is the answer of your first question. Similarly, you can solve question number second, question number third. Question number third is, I want to give you some hint, minus 1, 11 upon 8 and 5 upon 8. First of all, change the conditions of plus and minus symbol. You can write down these questions 5 upon 8 minus 11 upon 8. And you know that 11 is the biggest than 5. If you minus plus and minus, if you subtract that minus value into more than 5, then you can write down symbol in minus, like 5 minus 11 or 11 minus 5. Then you can write down here 6 minus 6 upon 8 and cancel out here 2, 3 is 6 and 2, 4 is 8. Then after 1, 2 is 2 and 2, 2 is 4, minus 1 upon 2. I am not solving, but I am giving a hint. Question number 4, 5 and 6. Also you can solve. Similarly, all questions are depend on that properties. You have to check that first of all your denominator same or different. Now we will discuss question number 2. Dear students, we are discussing about the questions exercise of first C, which is given in your page number 10. And open your page number 10 and solve question number 2. Question number 2 says that add the following rational number. You can don't bewilder because the question number 2 says that add 3 upon 4 and minus 3 upon 5. Dear students, in first question you can solve very easily because in that question denominator are same, but in condition denominator are not same, then we can find out the result. What is the first step? Remember that first step is, first of all, find out 5, you have to divide it by 2, 2 to the 4, in 5, they are not divided by 2, then we can write down same number here, same condition apply, and in the last we can divide it by 5, 1 and also 1, and multiply this terms, 2 multiply by 2 multiply by 5, and 2 to the 4, and 4, 5 here, 20. The LCM of 4 and 5 is 20, then you can solve 3 upon 4 plus 3 upon 5, LCM is 20, same condition because sometime I will discuss 4, 5 is 20 and 5, 3 is 15 plus 5, 4 is 20 and 4, 3 is 12 and in the last term 15 plus 12, 7 and 2, 27 upon 20. The answer of your exercise number first is second. The answer of 27 upon 20. The sum of 3 upon 4 plus minus 3 upon 4. The answer is 27 upon 20. Similarly, you can solve second question number, third questions, question number 4 also, fifth and 6. But I feel that you can feel a problem in question number 7. I can solve question number 7. Yeah, I will help you that 2 question number 7 say that add minus 1 plus 3 upon 4. Dear students, how can we solve this question? So first of all, in this condition, if not any type of remainder or not denominator in this fraction, then first of all you let on that positions 1. We can suppose that here is the denominator of the 1 of this equation. The question is that minus 1 upon 1 and plus 3 upon 4. And here is the denominator is different. Then same condition, first condition, that find out the LCM. LCM of the 4 and 1. Also you can find out 4. Then next procedure you can follow 4 and also. Then you can find out very easily what is the answer. And also you can solve question number 8 and 9. We will discuss question number 3rd. Stop. Okay dear students, now we are going to discuss about question number 3rd. Question number 3rd says that verify the following equations. Verify the following equations and question number 1st says that minus 12 upon 5 plus 2 upon 7 is equal to 2 upon 7 plus minus 12 upon 5. Dear students, this equation says that verify these equations. हमको ये verify करना है कि ये equation जो दिया है, ये सही दिया है क्या? इसके equal ये है या नहीं? इसको हमको जस्टिफाई या वेरीफाई करने के लिए सेम प्रोसीजर फॉलो करना होगा जैसा कि अभी हम लोगों ने पिछले क्लास में डिस्कस किया कि सबसे पहले हम इसका एलसीएम फाइंड आउट करेंगे. अगर फाइनल रिजल्ट हमें पता चल जाता है तो हम इसको इजीली वेरीफाई कर सकते हैं. नाउ लेट सी दैट यू कैन सॉल्व एंड यू कैन राइट डाउन दिस इक्वेशन 2 upon 7 minus 12 upon 5 is equal to minus 12 upon 5. Just here you can write down 2 upon 7 minus 12 upon 5 because I am writing a minus. Why? Because plus and minus is equal to minus and also here plus and minus also is a minus. So same procedure I am following that and with the help of that equation I am writing at 2 upon 7 minus 12 upon 5 and same here. We will find out the LCM. First of all LCM, what is the LCM of 7 and 5? What is the LCM of 7 and 5? First of all, you have to divide it by 2, but in this condition, you saw that 2 is not able to divide it in these terms, 7 and 5. So, you can divide it by, first of all, 5, 7 and 1, and in the last of 7, 1 and 1. 5 multiplied by 7. And here is the 35. LCM of the 7 and 5 is 35, and follow the same procedure, 7, 5 is 35, 5 to the 10. Minus 5 7 84 is equal to 10 minus is a plus symbol and also there is a plus symbol. Plus 10 and minus 84. Minus 84 term is more than 10, then we can write down in minus, because plus and minus is minus. Minus 74 upon 35 is equal to, so same properties is applying here, minus 74 upon 35. Dear student, you saw this equation that minus 74 upon 35 is equal to minus 74 upon 35. If 2 is equal to 2, then we can say that this property is right. So, according to this property, we can solve all type of questions. So, dear students, we will discuss further questions and we will discuss about more questions tomorrow classes. If you have any doubt, then you can say and you can message or you can ask any type of procedure, and I hope that we will remove all type of your problem. Thank you. Bye-bye.